When you finish the linking procedure, it is time to review your project. For reviewing the scheduled plan, press this icon or F9 from the keyboard. Pay attention to the current data date. I select the 2nd of March because the project start date is the 2nd of March. I press on schedule. The plan is in the loop. Maybe you will face your plans with these loops. Maybe not. Here I will explain to you how to solve the loop in scheduling. Loop is the repeated logic in the schedule. For example, when you link activity A to activity B with SS, then you link activity B to activity A with FS, here you make a loop. P6 cannot schedule until you eliminate all loops. Here, the first loop starts from the foundation and finishes with the foundation. The second loop relates to gypsum boards lining for walls. I go back to my plan and find the foundation to recognize the logic of this loop. I want to see predecessors and successors together. So I right-click on the detailed window, click on Customize Activity Details, and select Relationships. The logic here is, first, weatherproofing and lean concrete must finish, then foundation can start. For weatherproofing, we said that, first, lean concrete must finish. Then it can be a start. Foundation here is confused because two of its predecessors are linked together. This is the logic of this loop. It shows why it is wrong. Let me assign waterproofing to civil works. Lean concrete to waterproofing. Foundation to lean concrete. So, when I schedule, you see the first loop has disappeared. The second loop with 1,330 activity ID. I find it. By understanding its loop logic, it is clear now to me to remove conduits. I schedule. Then you see it is scheduled without loop warning. I have put this loop consciously for you to be fully familiar with this warning. Now it is scheduled. I want to cross-check the plan from Gantt chart. I check it, it is okay. I see nothing absurd. In the next lesson, we will get log reports.